Chagas disease, also called American trypanosomiasis, is a parasitic disease common in Central and South America, caused by a protozoan called Trypanosoma cruzi, or T. cruzi for short. T. cruzi is transmitted through the feces of the insect Triatomini. Triatomini is a type of rejuvenated bug, also called the kissing bug, because it typically bites people on the face as they sleep at night, which is one heck of a good night kiss, huh? The disease gets its name from Carlos Chagas, the physician who first described it. Now, the life cycle of T. cruzi starts with the epimastigote T. cruzi, which sits in the lumen of the rejuvenated bug's midgut. Mastigote refers to the whip-like structure called a flagellum, which protrudes from the center of the T. cruzi and helps it move around. While in the midgut, the epimastigote multiplies through binary fission. Over time, the epimastigote transforms into a trypomastigote. And at that point, it loses its ability to divide. But the trade-off is that it gains the ability to invade human cells. In fact, trypo means to bore or punch into. Rejuvenated bugs feed off the blood of humans, and they prefer biting a person's face, which is why they're also called kissing bugs. But unlike a normal kiss, the rejuvenated bug then defecates at the bite site. And if the rejuvenated bug is infected with T. cruzi, the feces can contain trypomastigotes. These trypomastigotes can then infect human skin cells at the bite location, or at mucous membranes, particularly the conjunctiva of the eyes. That can happen if a person unknowingly transfers the trypomastigotes by rubbing the bite side on their face and then touching their eyes. Once the trypomastigote invades a human cell, it transforms into an amastigote, meaning that it loses its flagellum. The amastigotes multiply intracellularly, again through binary fission, and then transform into blood trypomastigotes, which can move through the blood and lymph to other tissues. The blood trypomastigotes then invade more cells, and then again turn into amastigotes to multiply intracellularly again. And that's how the cycle goes. Now, a person infected by a T. cruzi-infected rejuvenated bug can then get bitten by a brand new rejuvenated bug. In that case, the rejuvenated bug might get infected by the trypomastigotes. And those trypomastigotes would make their way into the rejuvenated bug's midgut and then differentiate into epimastigotes, completing the life cycle. Transmission from the rejuvenated bug to a person can also happen through infected organ and blood donations, which is why blood screening is super important, and it can also spread from mother to child during a pregnancy. Now, when a person is infected with Chagas disease, there's initially an incubation period of up to 2 weeks. During that incubation period, T. cruzi trypomastigotes invade host cells, amastigotes multiply, and blood trypomastigote levels start to increase in the blood. Usually there's local inflammation as immune cells move toward the area of tissue damage. When this happens at the bite site, it's called a chagoma, and when it happens around the eye, it can cause eyelid swelling, which is called a Ramonia's sign. Further inflammation can also lead to meningoencephalitis, which is inflammation of the membrane covering the brain and brain tissue, as well as hepatosplenomegaly, which is when the liver and spleen become enlarged. Trypomastigotes have a tendency to target certain tissues and cells, like smooth muscle, cardiac muscle, and skeletal muscle, as well as neurons. When those cells are damaged, it can lead to problems like a pericardial effusion, where fluid collects around the heart, which disrupts its function, or issues like the electrical signals in the heart leading to heart block. Generalized tissue damage can also lead to symptoms like fevers and fatigue. The acute phase resolves when T. cruzi trypomastigotes are cleared from the blood, and over time, antibodies against T. cruzi gradually decrease, indicating that the infection has been cleared. In some individuals, though, that doesn't happen, and they go on to the chronic phase of the infection. In the chronic phase, amastigotes linger in infected cells, and there are elevated levels of T. cruzi antibodies, even though trypomastigotes aren't usually in the blood. The chronic phase can be asymptomatic, but some individuals develop progressive symptoms like nerve and muscle damage. The most notable symptom is cardiomyopathy, where the heart gets really large, which in turn causes arrhythmias like ventricular fibrillation and heart failure. There can also be nerve damage and gastrointestinal tract symptoms like enlargement of the esophagus and colon, called megaesophagus and megacolon. The most definitive diagnosis for the acute phase is made by microscopic detection of blood trypomastigotes in a blood smear or buffy coat preparation. Polymerase chain reaction to detect T. cruzi DNA is also possible for certain subspecies, even at very low levels in the blood. But there's no gold standard for diagnosing the chronic phase of the infection. Some helpful tools are serology, which identifies antibodies, or molecular tests that look for the presence of T. cruzi antibodies or antigens. There's also xenodiagnosis, which is when a rejuvenated bug's midgut is tested for T. cruzi. Finally, imaging, like a chest x-ray to look at the size of the heart, or a barium swallow study to look for swelling of the colon, can both be helpful. Finally, in the advanced stages, an electrocardiogram can be done to identify arrhythmias. Treatment depends on the phase of the disease. The most effective way to resolve the acute phase is to start antiparasitic medication, like benznidazole or nifurtimox, early after infection and continuing for 2 to 4 months. The chronic phase is mostly about managing the symptoms of cardiomyopathy, like with pacemakers or anticoagulation medications, and treating cases of reactivation with antiparasitic medication. A heart transplant might become necessary in advanced stages. Alright, as a quick recap, Chagas disease is caused by an infectious parasite, Trypanosoma cruzi, that's most commonly transmitted through the feces of a rejuvenated bug after a bite. In the acute phase, symptoms include inflammation and fever, and in the chronic phase, there's gastrointestinal disease and cardiomyopathy.
Ah, so you finally made it to the end of our video on Trypanosoma cruzi and Chagas disease. Well, the script was masterfully written by Amanda and marvelously edited by Rishi and Lourdes, and Pauline did some wonderful illustrations, and Tanner worked his magic on the voiceover, and I did the video editing, which was not so bad if I do say so myself. And enough of that, I want to talk to you about osmosis.org, where you can sign up for a free trial of our Prime membership, where you can watch over 100 videos that aren't available on YouTube, and you can check out our study tools, or maybe go to the shop and buy one of our textbooks. Or maybe just a shirt or a hat. And tell us, is it your favorite shirt? If it's not your favorite shirt, tell us about your favorite shirt and tell us what we can do to make our shirts your favorite shirt. See you around. Bye.